conference is held on March 3rd, 2016. And the location, place where we have is the global hall of our university, Meiji, in Tokyo. And we host the JMOOC host and co-hosting by Open University of Japan. It's the Tsuno Yamada's University. And supported by next Ministry of Education, Culture, Science and Sports and Science and Technology, and our university, Meiji University, and two organization, non-profit organization related to the higher education, JUICE and AXIS. And in this conference, 7 countries, regions, it's not spelled, but spelled. Those are Indonesia, Korea, Malaysia, Taiwan, Thailand, UNESCO, and Japan. Before the conference, we had the pre-conference meeting. It's on the March 2nd. We discussed about the statement we could share in the conference, and also talk about the NAS hosting organization. That is a photo, so you can see some of them here, and some of the person from Japanese, the special supporter of the JMOOC. In the center, two person, the president of the JMOOC, Dr. Shirai Katsuhiko, Katsuhiko Shirai, here, and he is the president of he was the previous. He was the president of the Meiji University, Fukumiya. This year, the presidential election held, and the next person. But anyway, those persons are got together, and we had a photo session here. And this is the statement we could share. We, the participants of Asia Regional MOOC Stakeholder Summit 2015, which was held in Tokyo on March 3rd, maybe 2016, share the vision that there is a huge potential of MOOC, not only for higher education, but also for lifelong learning for all in Asia region. We also agree that it is very important for all in Asia region to exchange experiences and practices in MOOC in order to propel the development and the application of MOOC in Asia. The one fruit of that statement will be come true in this March, I think. So thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much, Professor Yoshimi. And we now know that there is a momentum carry on from several years ago for ASEAN Regional MOOC meeting. So now let's hear from another person, Professor Li Ping Wang from UNESCO Bangkok. He will kindly share information on the initiative of Asia Pacific MOOC Stakeholder Summit. So please, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Good morning again. As you know, I'm working in the UNESCO Bangkok office, which is a regional office covering 46 member states in Asia and the Pacific. But actually, we are focusing also on Greater Mekong sub-region countries as well, because some regions are so far away, like Central Asia and the Pacific. But this year, we are able to cover more, to add more activities for the Pacific countries and also Central Asia. As you know, last year, you know, the World International Education Community just adopted a new global education agenda for education 2030, which is supposed to be universal, applied to all the countries. Compared with the previous one, this is universal, which means that if you are doing well, please share your experiences. But if you are not doing well, join UNESCO for capacity building, right? That's what I can understand for the universality of the new agenda. And I'm happy to see that actually in terms of development of MOOCs, countries like Japan, Korea, and Thailand, you are very much ahead of many other countries in developing a common platform, whether it's being financed by the government or in the form of cooperative, you know, activities like Japan. And it's very, very good for UNESCO to rely on Japan, Korea, and Thailand to provide more experiences in developing a common guidelines for other countries to follow. So this is actually what UNESCO is going to do. And I'm very happy that last year I was invited by JMOOC to attend this first Asia MOOC Stakeholder Summit, which was really good, and I'm so happy. And this year I'm happy to see that the second meeting will be hosted by Thai Cyber Universities, and we promise to try our best to mobilize participations to this March meeting. And we also noticed that not only these three countries, but also other countries like Malaysia, they have MOOCs. India also start developing a very good MOOCs platform. In China, they have several platforms also, which is very, very much used by people. So during last October, the meeting in Seoul, which are hosted by NIO, participants agree to actually increase regional collaboration in the policies and the best practices of MOOCs management, MOOCs platform development. And we also agree that for UNESCO to take the lead in launching a kind of Asia-Pacific MOOCs network, which I would also see not conflicting with all the existing meetings and the mechanisms, like the one you are going to sign, MOU, between Thai MOOCs, K-MOOCs, and JMOOCs. It's just supporting each other rather than conflicting with each other. And we also think that it's important for UNESCO to mobilize good experiences and good practices to benefit developing countries in this region, because we felt obliged to bring more experiences to developing countries. So this is one of our mandate, and we actually started the process in the year 2015, when UNESCO organized a first expert meeting in China with the participation of NIO and also JMOOCs also. In China, and then followed by the second meeting in Seoul. But this year, we are very keen to develop a concept note to launch this Asia-Pacific MOOCs network. And we are also thinking of consulting with K-MOOCs, JMOOCs, and Thai MOOCs during this meeting, if it's possible for us to launch a kind of publication which is of high impact. Database, evidence-based, may be published every biannual report to reflect the development of MOOCs in this region, if it's being supported by all the member states. So this is what we are going to do. But for the big picture, I think this is part of our effort to promote the use of technology in the delivery of higher education programs. We noticed that for traditional open university system, you are very much ahead of other traditional universities in developing this kind of MOOCs platform and management quality assurance. But for the traditional universities, we are also very keen to promote this kind of MOOCs, as well as blended learning, which is another focus for UNESCO Bangkok. We just published a book, and I think Wesley will share with you the link to the to download this our latest publication on blended learning, which we collected how many cases? 11 or from Seoul National University, I think from Chiang Mai University, universities in Australia, and also we have many cases also from China. So this is the latest book, and we are going to disseminate this common guidelines in Cambodia and Sri Lanka, because we collect, that's UNESCO's responsibility, right, to consolidate regional experiences and then to try to use it for developing countries. So we are going to launch another project in Cambodia and Sri Lanka targeting two flagship universities. One is IUPP, another is University of Kuala Lumpur, for capacity building in the use of blended learning for universities. And this is really quite exciting. I hope that in working together with our member states, especially Thai MOOCs, JMOOCs, and the KMOOCs, we are able to launch a big one to enable us to collect more best policies and practices to benefit developing countries. We are not a club of rich countries or, developed countries. We need to actually mobilize intellectual and the financial resources to benefit developing countries. So that's our mandate, and I hope that during the discussion we can really think of some possible projects that we can work together, and UNESCO can really play our roles as leading agencies in the field of education. And we are a multilateral platform, and I hope that we can really doing something together. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor Wang Liping from UNESCO Bangkok. Ladies and gentlemen, and we have heard the MOOCs initiative from three different regions. First, start with the Asia region, and then we have the Asia and Pacific, and then we end up with UNESCO level or ASEM. This is something important to all of us. And for us to continue our process together, we should have some kind of common understanding between us. So it takes us to our next agenda in the program, the concept and program draft for the first Asia-Pacific MOOC Stakeholder Summit. Now, I would like to invite you to please open the document called Event Planning Short Version. Oh, sorry, Professor. Oh, I'm sorry. Professor So.